YouTube world, my name is Nicholas Montez, and you're watching my YouTube channel, The Teenage Movie Critic, and welcome back to another YouTube channel, everybody. I'm so excited to have you all back here again, and in today's video, we're going to be doing a review series for X-Men the Animated Series from the 90s, to get ready for X-Men 97 next week. And it's a show that I've been interested in because, you know, it's proclaimed to be one of the best Marvel shows of the last couple years. It's also memorable. So I've been very interested to see what this show is about. So let's just go ahead and get started. And I've watched all five seasons the last 5 weeks. So with that said, let's just go ahead and get started talking about X-Men the Animated Series. And I'm going to be straight honest with you guys here. I think this show, as a Marvel fan, as a fan of the X-Men, I think the show is severely fine. To be clear, I love Marvel. Marvel is my favorite type of medium. Like, everybody loves Star Wars, everybody loves Harry Potter, Transformers, Lord of the Rings, King Kong, Godzilla. The best forms of fiction is what makes it great. And Marvel is great. And there is tons of people that love the X-Men franchise. However, and you know, I love the idea, especially back then, where you had these iconic comic book characters in these comics, and the idea to adapt them into live-action movies, and into animated movies, into live-action shows, and into animated shows. And I think probably the problem with doing this is I just kind of feel like this show is good. We'll talk about this in the bad, but obviously I think the best thing about this is the way that they were able to capture the look of all the characters from the way they look in the comics. That's obviously the best thing. The way that you kind of care about the characters, the way that it kind of goes into exact storylines, it makes you care about the characters. And obviously the next best thing is, of course, the theme score of the show as it plays throughout the entire beginning of the every season. Like, the score, the theme song is just incredible. So yeah, that's the positives on this one. Now let's move on to the bad. Now, to be clear, I don't have many issues with this show. But the reason why I just said it's just a fine show is because, obviously, like I said, I love that back in the day, we had the chance to see, you know, Spider-Man, X-Men, and all these other characters portrayed in animation with their comic book looks. But the problem with this is that, at least with this show, I just felt like it was just adapting exactly what was from the comics into animation. And for some, and you gotta know, not everything that's in the comics is going to work in animation. Part of the reason why I like the Marvel movies is because they find a way to adapt the story into live action and create something new and distinct with it that matches of what movie lovers love today. Like, the sequel to Captain America was a political thriller. You had Guardians of the Galaxy, where a character loved listening to music. Loved listening to 80s and 70s music. You had Spider-Man, which was inspired by John Hughes. You had Shang-Chi, with taking inspiration from Jackie Chan martial arts fights movies. And so you had all that. With this one, it's just putting the X-Men on the screen, and that's it. Possibly my favorite Marvel animated show is Spectacular Spider-Man, because it stays true to who the character of Spider-Man is, but it finds a way to do unique versions of everything of the Spider-Man world, in the Spider-Man lore. With this one, and maybe it's just because with the X-Men, I'm not as connected with the X-Men. I like the X-Men movies and everything. But maybe I'm just not as connected with the X-Men. That's why it's like Ninja Turtles, you know. My favorite Ninja Turtles is, of course, Mutant Mayhem, the Batman v Ninja Turtles one, and then, of course, the one from 2012 with on Nickelodeon. But every type of Nickelodeon show seems different. Maybe when I watch the Ninja Turtles shows from the animated, from like the 2003 80s show, maybe I wouldn't like it as much like this one because it just takes that style. But I don't know. Maybe it's just because I don't like classic. Like, I do like classic, you know, Marvel classic stuff. But for me, this show is not my favorite. It's good. There's a lot of uniqueness to it. I like that they actually brought the comics to the small screen for TV. But I wish that it kind of adapted the characters a bit more to make you care about them and make you just want to watch the X-Men. But that's my thoughts on X-Men, the animated series. I'm really sorry if you guys are disappointed in my thoughts. I do like this show. Is it a show I'll ever go back to? Probably not. I am somewhat looking forward to X-Men 97 since the animation style looks interesting to me. So I'm very excited for that. But overall, that's my thoughts on X-Men the Animated Series. Before I give my final score, please down below, what are your thoughts on X-Men the Animated Series? Did you guys love it? Did you guys hate it? Are you right there in between? Did you guys grow up with this show? And are you excited for X-Men 97 next week? Let's have a fun discussion down in the comments. And with that said, let's get on with my scores. Well, that's it for my scores. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.